Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen the biasing of the depletion type of MOSFET. So similarly, let us see the biasing of the enhancement type of MOSFET in this video. And before we jump into it, first let us quickly understand why we need to bias the MOSFET. Now although for the BJT and the JFET, I have already explained it in detail, but those who have not watched those videos, let me just quickly explain the need of the biasing. So here, we want to use the MOSFET as an amplifier. That means whenever we apply a small input to the MOSFET, then we should get the amplified signal at the output. But if we just apply a small input signal between the gate and the source, then we directly cannot get the amplified output. And that is because of the MOSFET characteristic. If you see the transfer characteristic of this enhancement type of MOSFET, then it starts conducting when the voltage VGS is greater than the threshold voltage. That means whenever we directly apply a small input signal of few millivolt between this gate and the source terminal, then the MOSFET will not get turned on. That means there has to have some DC biasing voltage which is greater than the threshold voltage. So that whenever we apply a small input on top of it, then the MOSFET will remain in the on condition. Apart from this voltage VGS, we also need to ensure the proper voltage at the drain terminal of the MOSFET. So as we have discussed previously, the MOSFET can be operated in the three regions. That is the linear region or the ohmic region, the cutoff region and the saturation region. Now whenever we want to use the MOSFET as an amplifier, then it needs to be operated in this saturation region. Because in this saturation region, if you observe, even if there is an increase in the drain to source voltage, then the drain current almost remains constant. So in this region, the MOSFET acts like a voltage controlled current source. That means by controlling the voltage VGS, the drain current can be controlled. And to operate the MOSFET in this region, the voltage VDS should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. And using the voltage transfer characteristic of the MOSFET, we can understand more intuitively why the MOSFET should be used in the saturation region for the amplification. So this is the typical voltage transfer characteristic of the MOSFET. And as you can see, it shows the relationship between the input voltage VGS and the output voltage VDS. So as you can see, when the voltage VGS is less than the threshold voltage, then the MOSFET will remain in the off condition. That means during this region, the voltage VDS is equal to VDD. Then the next region is the saturation region, where the voltage VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. And as we increase the VGS further, that means whenever the VDS is less than or equal to VGS minus VT, then the MOSFET will operate in the linear or the ohmic region. So as you can see from this curve, in this saturation region, it is possible to get the maximum amplification. That means on top of this DC biasing voltage, whenever we apply a small input signal, then it is possible to get the amplified output with the minimum distortion. And we will talk more about it during the small signal operation of the MOSFET. But the thing is, to use the MOSFET as an amplifier, it needs to be biased properly so that it operates in the saturation region and it can provide almost linear amplification. Now the easiest way to bias this MOSFET is by applying a fixed voltage between this gate and the source terminal. So here, since this gate current IG is approximately equal to 0, so there will not be any voltage drop across this resistor RG. That means in this case, this voltage VGS is equal to VGG. And on top of it, a small input signal can be applied through this coupling capacitor. But for the DC analysis, this coupling capacitor will act as an open circuit. So if this DC voltage is greater than the threshold voltage of the MOSFET, then the MOSFET will start conducting. And if it operates in the saturation region, then this drain current ID can be given by this expression, where this K depends on the device parameters. And if you see the exact expression, then the exact expression of this drain current is equal to 1 by 2 times mu n times COX times W by L times VGS minus VT whole square. So here, for the n-channel MOSFET, this mu n is the mobility of the electron in the channel, while this COX is the oxide capacitance. And this oxide capacitance depends on the thickness and the area of this oxide layer. Then this L is the length of the channel and the W is the width of the channel. So basically, this K depends on the device parameters. And during the fabrication, by varying any of these parameters, the relationship between the drain current and the voltage VGS can be changed. But as a circuit designer, when we want to use this discrete MOSFET as an amplifier, then these parameters are not known to us. And instead, in the datasheet if you see, for the particular value of the VGS, the drain current ID is given. That means if you see the datasheet, then for the VGS on, we have been given a value of the ID on. Now, academic perspective, in some examples, sometimes these device parameters are given, while sometimes the value of the VGS on and the ID on are given to find the value of the K. But using all these values or using all these device parameters, we can find the drain current ID at any given value of the VGS. Alright, so using this expression, for the given value of the VGS, we can find the drain current ID. Or vice versa, for the required value of the drain current, we can find the required value of the voltage VGS. So once we know this drain current ID, then by properly selecting this drain resistor, we can ensure that the MOSFET indeed operates in the saturation region. And the same can also be seen graphically. So here, this yellow line shows the load line. That means whenever the voltage VDS is equal to 0, then the drain current ID is equal to VDD divided by RD. And whenever this ID is equal to 0, then the voltage VDS is equal to VDD. So let's say the MOSFET is operated at VGS is equal to 4 volt. So the intersection of this load line with this VGS is equal to 4 volt curve will give us the operating point. That means this is the operating drain current and this is the operating value of the voltage VDS. Now here, if the value of the RD is too small or the too large, then the MOSFET may operate in the saturation region and we may not get the full voltage swing of the output. For example, if RD is too large, then the operating point may shift toward the ohmic region. And if the RD is too small, then the operating point may shift towards the VDD. And in either case, the voltage swing of this AC signal will get reduced. For example, if we consider this green line, then the maximum voltage swing will be equal to VDD minus VDS. That means for the AC signal, the maximum voltage swing is equal to VDD minus VDS. On the other end, if we consider this red line, then the maximum voltage swing is equal to VDS minus 0. That means as the operating point move towards the ohmic region or towards the VDD, then the maximum voltage swing for the AC signal will get reduced. So to get the maximum voltage swing for the amplified output and to ensure that the MOSFET operates in the saturation region, the value of the RD should be selected properly. Now although this fixed bias is very simple biasing technique, it is not a good approach to bias the MOSFET. The reason is, in this configuration, the biasing point is very susceptible to the change in the temperature as well as the other MOSFET parameters. For example, this mobility and this threshold voltage are the temperature dependent. That means with the temperature, the drain current ID will change. That means even if we keep the value of VGS fixed, then the drain current ID will change. Moreover, the other MOSFET parameters like the oxide capacitance and this W by L may vary from device to device. That means even if we take the two discrete MOSFETs of the same model number, then they might have slight difference in these parameters. And because of that, there will also be a slight difference in the device characteristic. So let's say these two curves shows the extreme variation in the device parameters for the two similar type of MOSFET. Now if the MOSFET is biased with the fixed gate to source voltage, then this is the maximum variation in the drain current for the two devices. That means in terms of the biasing stability, this fixed bias is not an ideal biasing technique. And this biasing stability can be improved using the voltage divider bias. So in this voltage divider bias, a fixed gate to source voltage is applied using the voltage divider. Because here, Since this gate current IG is approximately equal to 0, so the current is flowing through this resistor R1 and the R2. That means using these two resistors, we can decide the gate voltage. Now this voltage divider biasing configuration is particularly useful when only a single supply is available. So here, the AC input signal is applied using the coupling capacitor. But for the DC analysis, these coupling capacitors will act as an open circuit. So as I mentioned, here the gate voltage VG can be given as R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times VDD. And once we know this gate voltage, then by applying the KVL in this loop, we can find the relationship between the voltage VGS and the drain current. So in terms of the biasing circuit, if you see, there is an additional resistor RS at the source terminal. So if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can write voltage VG minus VGS minus ID times RS, that is equal to 0. Because here, the current which is flowing through this source resistor is equal to ID. And this ID times RS is the voltage drop across this resistor RS. So from this we can say that voltage VGS is equal to VG minus ID times RS. Now assuming the MOSFET is operating in the saturation region, the drain current ID can be given by this expression. So by putting the value of VGS from the previous expression and solving this quadratic equation, we can find the drain current for the given value of the voltage VG. And once we know this drain current ID, then by properly selecting the value of this resistor RD, we can ensure that the MOSFET is operating in the saturation region. Because if we apply the KVL in this outer loop, then we can write voltage VDD minus ID times RD minus VDS minus RD times RS, that is equal to 0. Or in other words, voltage VDS is equal to VDD minus ID times RD plus RS. So this is how we can bias the MOSFET using this voltage divider biasing configuration. Now let's see the biasing stability of this particular configuration. So let's say this is the transfer characteristic of one MOSFET, and this yellow line represents the equation voltage VGS is equal to VG minus ID times RS. That means whenever this ID is equal to 0, then this voltage VGS is equal to VG. And whenever this voltage VGS is equal to 0, then this drain current ID is equal to VG divided by RS. So the intersection of this line with the transfer curve will give the operating value of the voltage VGS and the drain current ID. Now let's say this is the transfer characteristic of another similar type of MOSFET. And let's assume that this is the maximum variation in the device characteristic for the similar type of MOSFET. So in this voltage divider biasing configuration, this is the maximum variation in the drain current. And as you can see, here the variation is much lesser compared to the fixed bias configuration. The reason is, there is an inherent negative feedback in this particular configuration. So let's say, for some reason, if the drain current ID increases, then the voltage drop across this resistor RS will also increase. And as we have seen, the voltage VGS can be given as VG minus ID times RS. So as the drain current ID increases, then the voltage VGS will reduce. And as the voltage VGS reduces, then the drain current ID will also reduce. That means this circuit prevents the increase in the drain current and it tries to maintain the drain current. That means by adding the source resistor, the effect of the variation in the MOSFET parameters can be minimized. Now whenever the positive and the negative supplies are available, then we can also bias the MOSFET in this fashion. So here, this gate resistor provides a DC ground at the gate terminal and it provides a high input impedance whenever we connect the AC input signal through the coupling capacitor. Now another biasing configuration that is commonly used with the MOSFET is the drain feedback biasing. So in this configuration, via this resistor RG, the feedback is provided from the drain terminal to the gate terminal. And here, the AC input signal is applied to the gate terminal via the coupling capacitor. But for the DC analysis, these coupling capacitors will act as an open circuit. Now here, since the gate current IG is equal to 0, so this drain voltage VD is equal to VG. Or in other words, we can say that voltage VDS is equal to VGS. And this voltage is equal to VDD minus ID times RD. Now assuming the MOSFET is operating in the saturation region, the drain current ID can be given by the following expression. And in this expression, by putting the value of the VGS from the previous expression, it is possible to find the value of the ID. So through the feedback, this configuration also tries to stabilize the operating point. So let's say somehow if the drain current ID increases, then the voltage VGS will reduce. And as the voltage VGS reduces, then the drain current ID will also reduce. So in this way, this circuit tries to stabilize the operating point if there is any change in the drain current. Alright, so in many textbooks, you may find these symbols for the enhancement type of MOSFET. And you might see the biasing circuit with these symbols. But this symbol also represents the enhancement type of MOSFET. Now, so far as we have seen, if there is any variation in the external parameters like the temperature, then there will be a change in the biasing point. But this voltage divider bias and the drain feedback bias tries to stabilize the operating point. But still, some variation will remain there. Because as we have seen, these mu n and the Vt are the temperature dependent. So if we want a more robust operating point, then the MOSFET can be biased using the constant current source. So this constant current source ensures that the drain current remains constant even if there is a change in the external parameters. Now this type of circuit is typically used in the integrated circuit as a MOS amplifier. And in the ICs, this constant current source is generated using the current mirror. So in the upcoming videos, we will also see that how the current mirror can be designed using the MOSFET. But for a moment, just assume that this constant current source is readily available, and using this constant current source, it is possible to bias the MOSFET in a more robust manner. And once we cover few examples for both P-channel and the N-channel MOSFET biasing on our second channel, then it will get more clear to you. But I hope in this video, you understood the need of the biasing and how the enhancement type of MOSFET can be biased in the different configurations. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for MOSFET videos.